Hello everyone, I am B. Uday Kumar, Assistant Professor of Physics, working in Dr. V.R.R. Government College at Chella. In our last video, we tried to understand the growth and decay of current in an LR circuit. And in today's video, we try to understand the topic of the chapter varying and alternating currents, which is the growth and decay of charge in CR circuit, right? So in today's video, we are completely dealing the chapter of the growth and decay of charge in CR circuit. Okay, fine. So coming to this one, so this is our second topic of the chapter, which is growth and decay of charge in CR circuit, where C denotes the capacitor whose capacitance is given by C, capital C, and R is the resistor whose resistance is given by capital R. So this is a circuit which consists CR circuit, okay, which consists a capacitor C and R, and hence we call this as CR circuit. So now in this CR circuit, there are two subtopics that we need to discuss. One is growth of charge and another one is the decay of charge. So you know that what is a capacitor, right? So it is a device which is used to store the charge, right? So initially, when you don't connect any battery to a capacitor, initially the charge that will be present on the capacitor will be zero. You know this. Once you connect the battery, automatically the capacitor starts charging. So that means the charge starts storing on the capacitor. So at a particular instant of time, if I assume that the charge that is present on that capacitor is taken as small q, then whatever the charge that is already stored on that capacitor opposes the further addition of or further storage of the charge on that capacitor, because of which a back EMF is induced even in case of CR circuit, which opposes the further storage of the charge. So this is the concept that is present in this case. Here, remember, this back EMF is arised whenever the battery is connected to that means whenever the capacitor whenever the battery is connected to the CR circuit. Anyway, as I just told you, there are two parts here. So one is growth of, we have to study the growth of charge, and another one is we have to study the decay of charge. So both the cases, growth and decay of charges, can be studied with the help of this diagram. It's a two-way key, right? So there is a two-way key here. So if I connect key K to A, this lower part of the circuit gets closed, and hence the capacitor starts charging. And if I disconnect K with A and connect K with B, whatever the charge that is already stored, it starts discharging. This is what happens in this CR circuit. Okay, anyway, and now let us try to understand what is the growth of charge. Okay, let me take the marker. So let us assume that we are studying now the growth of charge. Let us assume that this is a resistance whose resistance is taken as capital R. It is a capacitor whose capacitance is taken as capital C. This is a battery of EMF capital E, and if I connect this key with the A, what happens, that is what we have to understand. This is connected K with A. That means this lower part of the circuit gets closed, and hence current starts flowing in the circuit. Remember, once the charge starts storing on the capacitor, it means that automatically the current also will be flowing in the circuit. So let us assume that at a particular instant of time, the current that is flowing in the circuit is taken as I. And let us assume that at the same time, the charge that is present on this capacitor is taken as Q. Remember, this capacitor do have two plates, right? The first plate will be having positive charge now. Let us assume that the charge that is present on this capacitor is plus Q. Automatically, the other plate will be having a charge of minus Q. Okay, but while dealing the derivations, we only consider one charge. The total charge that is present on that capacitor is obviously, if I add up both the charges on both the plates of capacitor, obviously it will be zero. But we will not take the total charge. The charge that is present on one plate is taken. Okay, so that you try to remember. Okay, remember, because of this battery, actually only plus Q charge is created on the first plate of the capacitor, but because of the induction, on the second place, so on the second plate, on this plate, let me take the arrow, on this plate, second plate, the negative charge is created on the inner surface of the plate, and plus Q charge will be created on the outer surface of the plate, and that plus Q charge will be moved to negative terminal of the battery. So this is what happens actually. So that means due to this battery, actually only the positive charge that is created on the first plate has to be considered, okay, which is taken here as plus Q at time t. Okay, so now I hope that means the introduction part of the lower circuit is over now. So now let us try to understand what is going to happen in this case, right? For that, let me just erase everything. Okay, I'm again taking the point, marker now. So I have connected K with here, right? So initially, at time t is equal to 0, the charge that is present on this capacitor will be 0. Do you agree with me? Because initially there will not be any charge that is present on this capacitor. So now as time increases, the charge on the capacitor starts increasing. So let us assume that, for convenience I am taking, okay? Let us assume that plus one charge, plus, single plus is created on the first plate in 1 second. Let us assume so. Initially, when this plus one plus, single plus is going and depositing or storing on the first plate, it won't experience any kind of repulsion on it, because there was no charge present on that capacitor initially. The first charge, for convenience I have taken only single charge, right? Plus is taken as single charge. So when that first single charge is going and sitting on that first plate, it won't experience any kind of repulsion. So that you try to understand. So after some time again, what happens? One more, that means some additional charge goes and sits on this first plate again. Let us assume that in 1 more second, one more charge is going and sitting on this plate. But remember, when this second charge is going and sitting on the first plate, it experiences some repulsion caused due to the first charge that is already present on the capacitor. For the first charge, there was no repulsion force, but for second charge, there was some repulsion force which this second charge experiences due to the first charge. So that you have to understand. So now again, after 1 second, let us assume that one more charge is going and sitting on it. Okay, so now what happens? This plus charge, that means from this battery, plus terminal of battery, one plus goes and sits on the first plate again. But when the third charge tries to sit on the first plate, it experiences some repulsion force due to the two charges that were already present. So this is what you have to understand. So is that clear? So like that, as the time increases, the charge on the first plate increases. At the same time, the repulsion or the opposing force to the addition, further addition of the charge also increases. That further, that opposition is measured in terms of EMF again here, which we call it as back EMF. Is that clear? So at time t is equal to 0, the charge was 0. This is clear to you, I hope. But after some time, let us assume that the charge that is present on this capacitor is taken as Q. Now the potential of that capacitor, I can write it as, you must be knowing this formula, Q is equal to CV, where if you know C and Q, you can find the potential difference across the plates of the capacitor. So that means the potential that is developed across the capacitor, I can write it as V is equal to Q by C. So this is the back EMF that is created across the capacitor, which opposes the further addition of the charge. So I hope it is clear to you. So now in lower part of the circuit, there are two EMFs now. One is applied EMF, another one is back EMF. And that back EMF is nothing but Q by C. So now the total EMF is how much? Total EMF is nothing but E, capital E minus Q by C, because total EMF is nothing but the addition of both the EMFs, right? One is trying to increase the current. Which one is trying to increase the current? this applied EMF is trying to increase the current in the circuit and also try to increase in the charge on the capacitor, this E. But this V, which is present across the capacitor, is trying to oppose or stop the further addition of the charge, right? And hence, this is taken as negative. So now the total effective EMF in the lower part of the circuit, I can write it as capital E minus Q by C. And if I take the current at a time T, if I take the current that is flowing in the circuit at time T as I, then by using Ohm's law, we can simply write the equation of capital E minus Q by C is equal to I into capital R. Once you know this physical part, what is going to happen here, and remaining thing will be mathematical part. I hope that part you can easily understand, but try to understand the physical part now. So now this is the equation that I get, right? This is what I told you already. E minus Q by C is equal to I into R. But where I can write it as dQ by dt. But here in this slide, I have initially written this formula, right? Capital E is equal to I capital R plus Q by C. Even you can write this equation in this way. This is written by using Kirchhoff's voltage law. Okay? So I am not dealing Kirchhoff's voltage law again. There are two EMFs here. One is capital E, which is positive. Okay? And while moving on, what happens? This one. E is up, that means is capital E is trying to increase the potential, and this V is trying to oppose the increase of current, or capital E is trying to increase the current in the circuit, and capital E is also trying to increase the charge on the capacitor. But this V, which is developed across capacitor, is trying to decrease the current as well as trying to decrease the charge that is stored on the capacitor, and hence one is taken as positive, another one is taken as negative, and this will be equal to, by Ohm's law also you can say that this is capital small I into capital R will be the potential across the resistor. This is known to you, V is equal to IR. This formula you generally write it, right? V is equal to IR you get when only resistor is present, but here we have a battery of EMF V, and also we have a back EMF which is taken as V, and hence the total EMF I can write in this equation, in this way. Okay, the same equation I can write this as E is equal to I capital R plus V also. Can I? But this V is nothing but Q by C. So this equation is written over here. So E is equal to IR. Can you see this is E and we have IR, and in place of V, what is that? Q by C. So this is the equation. This is also you can write. Or else you can directly write this equation. But I, what is I here? The current that is flowing in the circuit. But what is this I? I can write it as dQ by dt, which is the rate of flow of charge, right? By definition, I can write I as dQ by dt. So replace dQ by dt in place of I. So if I do so, what I get? I get E, this Q by C is taken to the left hand side. And hence, if I do so, though I get E minus Q by C, which is equal to I in place of I am substituting it as dQ by dt, and I am writing R as it is. Okay, so now exchange the terms so that Q terms comes to one side and the T terms comes to the other side. Okay, so if I do so, what I get, you just check it out. So dQ, this entire E minus Q by C is taken to the right hand side, and this dT and capital R is taken to the left hand side, and LHS and RHS can be replaced, right? So if I do so, I get dQ is equal to this one, E minus Q by C is taken to the right hand side, and that right hand side is writing here, I am writing it here on the left hand side. Okay, so I get dQ by E minus Q by C, which is equal to, now this dT and R are taken to the other side, so I get dT by R. So that part I am writing it here. So this I can write it as, if I add this E and Q by C, or if I subtract minus Q by C, if I subtract Q by C from E, or if I add E and minus Q by C, this is what I am going to get. Just add these two, what I get by cross multiplication, I get EC minus Q by C, and that C is taken to the numerator. Okay, this I can write it as on right hand side, we have dT by R. Okay, so this equation, if I simplify, this C also can be taken to right hand side. If I do so, I get on left hand side, we will have dQ by EC minus Q, and on right hand side, we will have dT by RC. So this is the equation that I get on integrating the above equation. So on integrating the above equation, what do I get? I get minus log 3 base E in bracket EC minus Q. Okay, so if I integrate this equation, this is the equation that I am going to get. how are you going to get it? Let us try to do it. So this is what I am doing, integral dq, that means apply integration on both sides. If I do so, this is like ec minus q. Ec is a constant, yeah. E is constant, applied EMF, and C, capacitance, is also constant. And hence, EC is a constant now. And Q, so I am integrating with respect to Q, right? And hence, it is like integral 1 by X. What do you write? You write it as log X, right? Like that. So this becomes log EC minus Q. First term, this is what I am going to get. And then next, if you want to write, you can write it to be the AC also. Okay. What again, I have to differentiate this bracket part. If I differentiate that bracket part, I get log to, differentiation of EC, which is constant, is 0, and differentiation of minus Q is minus 1. So this is what I get on left hand side. So this will be equal to, if I 0 minus 1 is minus 1, right? So if I bring that minus to the front, it becomes minus log to the base E. And in brackets, I get this as AC minus Q. So this is the left hand side that I get. And on right hand side, what do I have? I have integral dt by RC, right? That means integral dt is t and RC is constant. Just write it as it is, and it becomes plus some constant of integration that is taken as capital E. You can see this. This is left hand side, minus log to the base E, AC minus Q. Can you see this one? Minus log E to the base E in brackets AC minus Q, which is equal to, on right hand side we have t by rc and also constant of integration. Okay, this is written by using mathematical formulas. Okay, so now I have to find the value of this constant of integration. How do I find? Just apply the boundary condition. What is that? You know that at time t is equal to 0, the charge that is present on the capacitor is 0. I just explained it at the beginning of the class. So when time t is equal to 0, q is equal to 0. This condition is applied in equation 2. If I apply this condition, what happens? Minus is written as it is, log to the base E comes as it is. In brackets, I get EC minus Q, but in place of Q, I am substituting this condition. Q is 0 when time t is 0. So where is t? On right hand side you have this, right? So t is on right hand side. So in place of t, if I substitute 0, in place of Q also, I should substitute 0. This is the condition. If I substitute that, the equation will be minus log e to the base in brackets ec minus 0, and on right hand side I get 0 in place of t by rc, and dA will be written as it is. So now let us, that means 0 you can forget about it, and hence I can write dA as minus log to the base e in brackets q0. What is this q0? Q0 is nothing but the maximum charge that can be stored on the capacitor. Maximum charge, and that maximum charge is taken as EC is equal to Q0. I hope it is clear, right? So in place of EC, I am substituting it as Q0, which is a constant, right? So now substitute 3 in 2. If I do so, on right hand side, what do I get? I get minus, this is 2, minus log to the base E in brackets. EC is taken as Q0, and hence Q0 minus Q is written as it is equal to right side. In right hand side, we have T by RC. And plus A, right? But what is this A? E is found to be minus log to the base Q0. Substitute that and simplify it. So now this is the equation that I got. This minus log to the base is sent to the left hand side, or this is sent to the right hand side. Whatever the calculation that you want to do, you can do it. But you have to rearrange it in such a way that you get a proper equation. So I have sent what I have done. I have sent this minus log E to the minus log E in brackets Q0 minus Q to the right hand side. If I do so, what happens? It becomes plus. And that right hand side terms are written on left hand side. That you check it out. So if I send this to right hand side, what I get? Plus log to the base E in brackets Q0 minus Q. That is what I get. Okay, can you see this? This one. Plus log to the base E in brackets Q0 minus Q. And what will be left? Minus log to the base C Q0. That is also there. And one more term, we have T by RC. Now this T by RC is brought to the left hand side. If I do so, I get minus T by RC. And that LHS I have written on RHS. So that term I get here. Okay? I hope you understood this. So now we know that log M minus log N is log M by N. Apply that formula. If I apply, I get log to the base c in brackets q0 minus q by q0, which will be equal to minus t by rc, and apply exponential on both sides, and because of that this becomes q0 minus q by q0 log is, that means we are applying exponential on both sides, and hence this gets cancelled and we will have exponential on right hand side. So this becomes q0 minus q by q0, which is equal to exponential minus t by rc. So if I simplify this, q0 by q0 becomes 1 minus q by q0. This is the equation that I get. This I can write it as exponential minus t by rc. Okay, and then next, if I send this minus q by q0 to right hand side and write that right hand side term on left hand side, what do I get? I get q by q0 is equal to 1 minus exponential minus t by rc. So this is the equation that I get. Okay, I hope wait a minute. Okay, so I can write this q by q0 is equal to 1 minus exponential minus t by rc. So now if I send this q0 to the right hand side, I get q is equal to q0 times in bracket 1 minus exponential minus t by rc. So this is the equation that I get. Okay, so now this is the variation of charge with respect to time that I am getting here. So now the variation of charge with respect to time is the function of exponential here. Exponential function in terms of t we have. So if I take that charge on y-axis and take time on x-axis, the variation or the growth of charge with respect to time graphically can be represented with this equation. So I hope it is clear. So this is nothing but the variation of the charge on the capacitor with respect to time, and this variation is nothing but the growth of charge. Okay, so you just try to understand that, and then next let us just move on to our next slide. So this is now we are trying to understand what is time constant. Okay, from equation 4, so this is the equation 4 which shows that variation of charge with respect to time. So if I take that equation, q is equal to q0 in brackets 1 minus exponential minus t by rc, I can write this equation as, so that means I can find charge by substituting the value of time here, right? So let us assume that if I take that time small t as rc, which is taken as time constant, we already have studied this time constant in our last topic, which is in LR circuit. Even in this topic also we are getting the time constant, but here in case of RC circuit the time constant is taken as RC, so that the entire equation is simplified into a simple value. Okay, if I take that T as RC, which is equal to RC, that is called as time constant, and hence this time constant is mentioned with tau. So if I mention it with tau, what happens, this in place of RC I can write it as tau, right? So that is what I am doing. So q I can write it as q0 in brackets 1 minus exponential in brackets minus t by rc. This rc is nothing but tau. Now if I substitute this value of rc in this equation, okay, are you getting me? So remember, the time constant is taken as rc. Because of that this entire equation is written as q0 in brackets 1 minus exponential minus t by tau. But if time t is taken as rc, if I type that time as rc, which is equal to time constant, you know that when time t is equal to 0, this entire term you can calculate it, right? If I calculate it, it becomes 1 and 1 minus 1 becomes 0. You know that at time t is equal to 0, the charge present on the capacitor is 0. That condition we can calculate here also. So as you increase time, the charge decreases, right? Sorry, the charge increases. As time is increased, the charge that can be stored on the capacitor starts increasing. So now my aim is to find the value, that means to define the time constant. Here the time constant is taken as RC, and if time t, small t, is equal to RC, what happens to the charge? That is what I have to find. So when or if t is equal to RC, what happens to this equation? Let us check. So this becomes q is equal to q0 in brackets 1 minus exponential in brackets minus In place of small t, I am substituting rc. By tau is also equal to rc. This is equal to that part. So exponential minus rc by rc, that means these two gets cancelled, and hence you get exponential minus 1. So now this exponential minus 1, I can write it as 1 by e. So please check it out, this is the same. So q0 in brackets 1 minus exponential minus 1, and that exponential minus 1 can be written like this, and this exponential minus 1 I can write it as 1 by e, but you know that e is equal to 2.718, and if I substitute this 2.718 in place of e, I get this equation. So try to simplify it. If I simplify q0 in brackets e minus 1 by e, I can write it as q0 times in bracket 2.718 minus 1 by 2.718. This is the equation that I get. And if I solve this, I can write this as q0 in bracket 1.718 by 2.718. If I solve this, I get it as 0.63. And this 0.63, I can write it as 63% of q0. So that means the value of q will be 63% of q0 when time t is equal to rc. This is what you have to understand. With the help of this mathematical equation, I can define what is time constant. So the time constant rc can be defined as the time in which the charge increases to 63% of the maximum charge on the condenser. So the maximum charge that can be stored on the capacitor is q0, and the time constant is defined as the time which is equal to rc in which the charge that can be stored on the capacitor is 63% of the maximum charge. This is one definition of time constant. And if I differentiate this equation 4 with respect to time, I get current. Is that clear? So I can write I is equal to, if I differentiate q, I get dq by dt, which is equal to d by dt of this q is nothing but this one, q0 in brackets 1 minus exponential t, there must be some minus here, I missed it, exponential minus t by rc. So this is the equation that you should get. I'm just taking arrow again. So take this q0 outside. If I take this q0 outside, d by dt of 1 minus exponential minus t by rc, this is what I get. So let me simplify this here on the right hand side, d by dt of in brackets 1 minus exponential minus t by rc. This is the equation that I have, right? So this d by dt of 1 is 0, and hence I get 0 minus, we have minus here, right? And differentiation of exponential is exponential only, minus t by rc. Okay, and again I have to differentiate this minus t by rc. If I do so, I get minus 1 by rc again. Okay, so this is minus, this is also minus, that means minus and minus becomes plus, right? Okay, so remember, so this is what, and that means here I get 1 by rc times e power minus t by rc. This is the equation that I get. So the same equation you can see here. So anyway, this q0 is written outside the bracket, and the differentiation of this bracket I have measured here, and that value is found to be 1 by rc or 1 by c, they are same, right? And e power minus t by rc, this is the equation that I got, right? And this equation I can write it as q0 minus q by cr, q0 minus q by cr. So this is the equation that I can write. How you can write it? From equation 4, you know that q minus q0, q by q0 minus 1, I can write it as minus exponential minus t by rc. This is from equation 4, you can check it out. Okay, or else you can see here, this is q, right? This is equation 4. Q is equal to q0 into 1, I can write it. Okay, anyway, from equation 4, or else if you want to see, you can see here, this one, this part, I'm speaking about this. Okay, this is the equation that I am speaking. So if this minus q by q0 is taken positive, what happens if I take it as positive, this becomes minus, this also becomes minus. That equation is written over here. Q by q0 minus 1 is equal to minus of exponential minus t by rc. So if you simplify it, you get q0 minus q by q0, which is equal to exponential minus t by rc. So if you observe carefully, this q0 minus q by q0 is equal to exponential minus t by rc. So we have here this term, exponential minus t by rc. This is nothing but q0 minus q by q0, right? And because of that, the denominator we have, or else let me take this one, this is nothing but q0 by cr, and what is exponential minus t by cr? This is nothing but 0 minus q by q0. This is the equation that I get. And hence this q0s get cancelled. And the remaining will be q0 minus q by cr. So this is the equation of current that is flowing in the circuit. So like that, once you can write the starting equation by using the physical part, which is E minus Q by C, this one, E minus Q by C is equal to R into dQ by dt. And with the help of mathematics, you can find the charge that can be stored on the capacitor at a time t, and that charge equation is given by this one. And if you differentiate this equation, you can also find the current that can be flowing through the circuit at a time t. So this is what you have to understand. And from the above equation, the rate of growth of charge. What is rate of growth of charge? This is dq by dt, which is nothing but current. So the rate of growth of charge, that is current, in a circuit is smaller. Okay, let me take the arrow. It will be smaller when the time constant is larger. Remember, this CR is nothing but time constant, right? So this time constant and this current, they are inversely proportional to each other. If CR is larger, I will be smaller. If CR is smaller, I will be larger. So from this equation, you can say that the rate of growth of charge, that is current in the circuit, is smaller when time constant is larger. If time constant is smaller, current will be larger. So that is what you have to understand. Okay, so if CR is larger, current decreases. So that point is mentioned here. And also, so one more thing. Current decreases as the charge on the capacitor increases. Do you agree with me? Because as time increases, you know that this Q increases. If this Q increases, I decreases. Are you getting me? Why? Because we have in the numerator, which is equal to Q0 minus Q, right? So if Q decreases, I increases. If Q increases, I decreases. So this is what you have to understand. So now the behavior of capacitor. So when capacitor is gradually charged, it offers resistance to the due to the back EMF, which increases due to the increase in the charge on the capacitor. I discussed all these things at the beginning of the topic. And becomes infinite when capacitor is fully charged. Remember, once the capacitor is fully charged, it will not allow the further storage of the charge. And hence, the back EMF becomes infinite. So once the back EMF is infinite, no further charge can be stored on the capacitor. I already explained this one, right? But you have to understand, once the capacitor is charged, it cannot store further charge, right? If it cannot store further charge, what does it mean? It means that, at that point you can see here, when capacitor is fully charged, resistance is infinite. It's like resistance is infinite. It will not allow the charge, further charge, to store on it. It will completely stop it. Completely stopping means what? The resistance will be infinite once the capacitor is fully charged. And once the capacitor is fully charged, since further charge is not depositing on the capacitor, no current will be flowing through the circuit. This is what you have to understand. This point you need to understand. This one is important. Where is that marker? Okay, yeah. Once the capacitor is fully charged, no current flows through the circuit. So that means that point you can understand even from here. Once Q is maximum, if Q is maximum means what? Q becomes Q0. Once Q is becoming Q0, Q0 minus Q is how much? 0, right? And hence current will be 0. So that is what you have to understand. Once the capacitor is fully charged, it will not allow further deposition of charge on the capacitor, because of which the current in the circuit becomes 0. Okay, so that you have to understand. Similarly, when charge on capacitor is 0, maximum current flows. This is what you have to understand. When Q is 0, initial point, starting point, and time t is equal to 0, Q is 0, right? When time t is equal to 0, this Q is 0, and hence, since Q is 0, I will be maximum. Okay, maximum current flows in the circuit. So, capacitor blocks direct current when it is fully charged. So, what you have to understand here is that the capacitor, when it is completely charged, it will not allow the current to pass through it. So that means it just blocks the current that is flowing in the circuit. So that is what you have to understand. Okay, so this is the growth of charge and the growth of current in the circuit, in SCR circuit, that we have discussed. In our next topic, We will discuss the other part of this topic, which is decay of charge and also the decay of current in SCR circuit again. Okay, so remember, we completely concentrated, we are trying to understand the growth of charge and current in SCR circuit, growth of charge and a current in SCR circuit in today's video. But in our next video, we will try to understand how the charge is decayed and the current starts decreasing in SCR circuit. And that happens automatically when the key is disconnected from A and it is connected to B. So this is what happens in our next case. Okay, so that case we will discuss in our next topic. I will stop here. Thank you. We will meet in our next video.